Hi, I'm Gary Eckstein from organicweb.com.au. I'm a Mailchimp Pro Partner and Digital Marketing Consultant. Today, I will be answering a few questions about Mailchimp and images and files in general. I'm going to be answering four questions, and as per always, if you have any questions, please leave a comment on one of my YouTube videos, subscribe to my channel, please like this video, and so on. So why do I get an undefined error when I upload an image into Mailchimp? The second question, what size must my image be for email campaigns? How do I make my image bigger in an email campaign? And last, how do I show a PDF file in a Mailchimp email? Okay, let's deal with this first question. Why do I get an undefined error when I upload an image into Mailchimp? We'll go across to Mailchimp and I'll just describe what is happening here. So if we go into our Content Studio, so I've clicked Content Studio to the left-hand side of the screen, and I'll just click on My Files. So the Content Studio is where we upload our files for use in our Mailchimp campaigns, whether that's on our website that we create in Mailchimp, whether that's social media posts, whether that's an email we send. You can see I have various images here already. So the question was, why do I get an undefined error when I upload an image into Mailchimp? So let me just illustrate this, and just bear with me because this might just take a few seconds. I'm going to just from my other screen, I'm just going to drag and drop a file. It's a Word file, and I'll just drag and drop that across just to upload it into Mailchimp. I could have clicked upload, and you'll notice that at the moment that file is uploading. Now, the types of files we can upload into Mailchimp are image files such as JPG or JPEG, GIF, GIF, PNG, PDF, Word, Excel, CSV, those common sort of file types. Now, there was a quick flash at the bottom there that you may have seen, and it explained the issue, but this is the error here, undefined. What's going on here is that the maximum file size we can upload of a file, whether that's a PDF file, whether that's a Word document, image, etc., that we can upload into our Content Studio in Mailchimp is 10 megabytes. If the file that we're trying to upload into Mailchimp is greater than 10 megabytes, we get this undefined error. Now, 10 megabytes is a very big file size. So this is, you know, it's actually quite a, it allows, 10 megabytes is a lot. So if yours is over 10 megabytes, it is honestly way too big for people to download via email and so on. So try and make it smaller. Alternatively, if there is a file that is over 10 megabytes that you need to link to, for example, a PDF file and so on, the best thing to do is don't try and add it to the Content Studio in Mailchimp. Rather, upload it into Dropbox, Google Drive, Microsoft OneDrive, etc., as those file storage systems will accept large file sizes. Let's go on to our second question. What size must my image be for email campaigns? What size must my image be for email campaigns? So let's go into campaigns, and I'll just go into the new builder. The new Mailchimp email builder, and I'll click edit. So what size do our images need to be? Well, it is actually very flexible. So I'm going to click edit design, and I'll just illustrate very quickly. So we're in the new email builder in Mailchimp, and if I just click on the plus, I can add an image. So I'm going to click on image, the image content block. And again, I'm in my Content Studio, so we can upload a file or use one of our files here. So here are the guidelines. So it needs to be in file size, less than or maximum 10 megabytes, but try and make it as small as possible. But in regards to dimensions, it's actually very lenient and flexible. The width of an email we send is typically around about 600 pixels, but try and make every image you upload into MailChimp for use in email marketing, try and make every single, try and make every image a minimum of 800 pixels wide. And you can make it as high as you want to, but wide, try and make it a minimum of 800 pixels wide. Don't make it too wide because that'll increase your file size, but a minimum of 800. And I'll illustrate. So, but MailChimp will actually resize it down for you. So let me illustrate. So let's say I'm adding an image and this image is 2000 pixels wide by 200 pixels high. So let's just click on that. So 2000 pixels high, I'll click insert. And you'll, you'll notice that MailChimp has automatically reduced the size for us. So it makes it look good, even though it's larger. Let's do one more thing and I'll click the plus and click image. And I'll now add an image that's 200 pixels wide. So this is less than that minimum I noted of, let's say 800. So 600, but make it 800. So let's add one 200 pixels wide. I'll click insert. And what you'll notice is that although we can center it, etc., it doesn't take the full width. Even if we try and increase the width and so on, MailChimp in this case isn't allowing us to. The thing is, with an image, and not an SVG image, but email, let's call it acceptable image file types, which are very typically JPG or JPEG, PNG and GIF. We can't, or if we make a small image bigger, it pixelates, it destroys the quality. So always, please, don't add images that are less than 800 pixels wide into MailChimp. You can make them as wide as you want, but try and make them 800 pixels wide. That's probably, 800 to 1,200 is probably the ideal width. One more thing. Oh, sorry, two more questions. How do I make my images bigger in an email campaign? Oh, well, we've already discussed that. We can't actually make them bigger for a very good reason, that our image quality will be lost and it just won't look good. Rather get your image size bigger than need be and add it to MailChimp. How do I show a PDF file in a MailChimp email? This question I get asked often. Some people will save their images on a PDF file, or they'll have their text and images on a PDF file. They then want to create an email from that PDF file. PDF is not HTML. HTML is the code, the language, whatever you want to call it, the script that we use to create emails. That's HTML. PDF is something different. An analogy, I suppose, is some cars run on electricity, some cars run on petrol. Now, we can't add a PDF to HTML. It's just totally different. It just doesn't work. The same thing as if you've got an electric car, you're not going to try and put petrol into where the electricity goes. It's not going to end well. It just doesn't end well. Two different things. You can certainly link in MailChimp using a button or a link. You can link to a file, but we can't embed or show the PDF information in the actual email itself. It's just a totally different language. HTML is email, PDF is something entirely different. But those are those four questions about images and MailChimp. And I'm actually going to speak about something quickly. I've just got it on the top of my mind, sorry. So I thought I'd just mention it quickly because someone did ask me this and I thought I'll just quickly mention it. On each image we can add in MailChimp, we can add something here called alt text. We can add alt text, alternate text. What that is we describe that image, just in a few words. If it were an image of people at a waterfall, you would just put there, people at a waterfall. If it's your logo, you would just type logo, etc. We do this for two reasons. The one reason is if images don't show. So when we send an email, it's possible that the recipient has images turned off, so the images don't load for them. At least then the person will see that alt text, people at a waterfall, for example. The other reason is that for people using screen readers, for accessibility reasons, and especially if you're a government department and so on, you might be aware of WCAG, Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, which also applies to email, in that we need to have alt text for people using screen readers so that where they can't see the image, for example, the screen reader might speak it to them. people at a waterfall, and so on. So please always, always, always add alt text for every single image you're using. Please like this video, leave a comment, subscribe to my channel. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.